My name is Dan Fruit, and this is Pang, a podcast about real families who are hungering for change. This is episode one, Los Angeles. We interview families around the country who have one thing in common. They're not always able to afford enough healthy food. We work closely with these families to adapt their stories into audio theater. What's audio theater? You'll find out in about 30 seconds. The voices you'll hear are those of actors, really good actors, who are part of Pang's creative team. I'll introduce them and the rest of the team at the end of the episode. Our intention for Pang is not so much to learn about hunger and food insecurity as it is to get to know people who live with it. And as we came to know the Los Angeles family, whose story you're about to hear, we learned that when you're desperately trying to hold on to your home, you're not always thinking about being hungry. So, we began with the question, what does hunger sound like in America? And the answer we got is not what we expected.
America's Servicing Company, how may I direct your call?
Yes, my name is Gregorio Obinaldo.
Hold on. America's Servicing Company, please hold. Okay, yeah, Greg?
Yes, my name is Gregorio Obinaldo.
Uh-huh.
I refinanced my home a few years ago, but now
hold on, Greg. America's Servicing Company, please hold. Yeah, go ahead.
I refinanced my home a few years ago, and not now, Judah. I'm on the phone. Ask Yolanda to tie your shoe.
Yolanda!
Now I can't afford my monthly payments.
Uh-huh. You want to modify your home loan?
Yes.
Address?
To 2656 Brighton Avenue in Los Angeles, 900...
Okay, let me take your name and number, and I'll have one of our service representatives call you back.
It's Gregorio, and G-R-E-G-O...
Hold on, Greg. America's Servicing Company, please hold.
This is Gregorio Obinaldo.
Uncle.
I called last week about a loan modification for 2656 Brighton Avenue.
Uh-huh.
And you said somebody would call me back. It's 2656
uh-huh.
Brighton Avenue,
B-R-I-G. Uncle.
Look, it's been a week. Hello?
Yeah, I'm here, Greg.
Gregorio, and nobody has called me back.
Yeah. Service representatives call you back.
Gregorio, G-R-E-G-O.
Hold, please.
Come on.
Thank you for contacting America's Servicing Company, your one-stop location for managing your home loan. Your call is important to us. Please continue to hold, and your call will be answered in the order in which it was received.
While you wait, I'll tell you about Gregorio's house, which he shares with his niece, Beatrice, and her nine children. It's a beautiful two-story bungalow, five bedrooms, light green shutters, dark green trim, right on the corner of Brighton Avenue and West 27th Street, in the West Adams District of South Los Angeles. Next time you're in the neighborhood, you should definitely check it out. So America's Servicing Company never gets back on the line, and eventually Gregorio gives up. He's a busy guy, 78 years old, retired school teacher, and in his words,
full-time poor people's activist.
And he directs the St. Agnes Catholic Church Choir.
Three, four.
It's good, Mary.
And every Sunday morning before Mass, this is what the living room at 2656 Brighton Avenue sounds like. Until that is, one Sunday morning, in the spring of 2014.
Sorry, everyone. Sorry. Now, who could that be? I'll be right there.
I got it, Uncle.
Oh, why, thank you, Cahill. Let's go together and see who it is. Yes?
Good morning. My name's Rex, and I'm really sorry to barge in on you like this. I was just walking by on my way to church, and I heard this beautiful music, and I just had to see where it was coming from.
Oh, well, this is the choir from St. Agnes.
Hi, everyone. You sound like angels.
We always need a place to practice before Sunday Mass, so here we are.
Well, lucky for me. And my wife and I go to St. Paul's, but we'll definitely come to St. Agnes sometime just to hear you all again. I thank you. And what'd you say your name was, brother?
Gregorio. Gregorio Opinaldo, and this is my grandniece, Cahill.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Salonga.
Nice to meet you too, young lady. You and your uncle have a beautiful home, and my wife Rebecca and I are in the real estate business. So we see a lot of homes in South Los Angeles, and this is one of the finest I've seen in a while. Very well cared for.
Yes, well, my mother bought it in 1950, and now I'm 75. It's been in the family a long time. I love this house, Rex.
What a blessing. What a blessing. Well, again, sorry to bother you, Mr. Opinaldo. Opinaldo, that's a Filipino name, isn't it?
Yes, that's right. On my father's side.
Well, me too. On both sides. Small world, huh? Hey, really nice to meet you, everyone. I hope to see you at St. Agnes.
Actually, Rex, wait a minute. Let me ask you, Cahill, why don't you go see if your mother needs a hand changing the oil on the truck?
But Mom always changes the oil
in by fact, her... why don't you, take over for her? Ask her to come in here for a minute, please.
But...
Cahill?
Okay, Uncle, I'm going.
Ma! Uncle wants you in the living room.
Rex... what end of the real estate business are you and your wife in?
Oh, Rebecca and me? Oh, we just run a little tiny shop, you know, mostly for folks in the neighborhood, help out with lines of credit, refinance, servicing home loans, things like that.
Really? Well, if that's not the Holy Spirit at work,
it's really not all that exciting, Mr. Opinaldo. We just try and help where we can, you know?
Gregorio, call me Gregorio. Please, Rex, would you come inside?
Thank you, but I really don't want to be late to church.
This will just take a moment, Rex. Please.
Okay, Mr. Opinaldo, but I don't want to impose on you too long, and I really don't want to keep the wife waiting, you know?
Yes, yes, yes. Please, come in.
Beatrice?
Quick reminder, Beatrice is Gregorio's niece.
Beatrice? Where is that woman?
In 2014, when this story begins, she's 38, elder care worker, mother of nine, auto mechanic.
I'm here, Uncle.
Oh, good. Beatrice, this is Mr. Salongo.
Salonga, actually. Nice to meet you, Beatrice.
Oh, sorry. I can't shake hands. I've been changing the oil and
Right. Ma? Would you be so kind as to show Mr. Salongo around the house while I finish choir practice?
But Mr. I really don't have time.
Of course I will, Uncle.
Ma?
I'm in the living room, Nathaniel.
There you are. Can you take Baby Ephraim back, please?
Nathaniel and Baby Ephraim, along with Cahill, are three of Beatrice's nine children.
I can't take him right now, Nathaniel. Can you hold on to him just a little bit longer?
No, why always gotta?
Okay.
So, Gregorio continues his choir practice, Nathaniel minds Baby Ephraim, and Beatrice gives Rex a tour of the house, even though he needs to get to church.
What a cozy dining room. You must have served up a lot of meals here, Beatrice.
Actually, my Uncle Gregorio's the main cook in our house, Rex.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm. He became a vegan when I was 11 years old. Huh. Now, I may have been hungry now and again, but getting used to his vegan cooking was the closest I ever came to starving to death. I would say, I don't want to eat that, Uncle. What is it?
Quick flashback to 1987.
It's called adobong sitaw.
It's called what?
Adobong sitaw, Filipino vegetarian chicken adobo. I make it just like your grandmother used to.
Do I have to eat it?
You don't have to eat anything, but you do have to help clean the dishes.
Those kinds of memories are what make a house a home, Beatrice.
Yeah, I suppose.
I bet this whole house is full of family memories.
Oh, it is. It's full of memories. Some good, some not so good.
Here's an example of the not-so-good. Back in 1992, Beatrice was 16 and her sister Sienna was 14. They had two older sisters as well, But the house had only one phone, in the alcove at the foot of the stairs.
Yo, I got it.
No, I got it.
So at a certain point...
Oh my God, I said I got it, Sienna.
No, I said I got it, Beatrice.
There were four teenagers.
Oh, get out of my way.
No, get out of my way.
Sharing a single phone.
You stop, it's for me.
No, it's for me.
And an old school answering machine.
Hello.
Man, now look what you did.
I didn't do nothing.
Beatrice Johns, Delilah Johns,
Sienna, let me pick
Laurel
off
Johns,
the phone.
No!
Jaja Johns and Sienna Johns, please leave a message after the beep. Hey, Beatrice, how you doing? This here's Deshaun.
No. Stop.
I'm just calling to say last night was real cool.
Get out of my way.
No chance, Beatrice.
I can't wait to see you again. Hey, what you doing tonight, girl? Because I was thinking maybe we could get together again and, you know, do more of what we was doing last night.
I'm going to kill you.
But, you ain't home, so.
No.
It's
wait,
cool.
Wait, Deshaun, I'm home.
I guess I'll check you another time.
Stop it.
Deshaun.
Oh, wait, Sienna, let go!
Ew.
Hello, Deshaun, I'm here. It's Beatrice.
Uh-huh.
Deshaun, man!
Let's catch up with Beatrice's tour of the house. She and Rex just went out the back door.
Beatrice, I'm afraid I really can't stay much. Wow, this is a big backyard. Is this house on a double lot?
Yeah, I think this backyard's one of the reasons my grandmother bought this house in the first place.
And that old stone barbecue.
Oh, yeah, my grandfather built that. That old grill was there, the whole neighborhood would gather. My grandparents loved to entertain, invite absolutely everyone.
I bet that was a nice way to grow up.
Yeah, it was. When I was a little girl, my grandfather would be sweating over the barbecue, yelling at me to stay out the
neighbor's
business.
This is your house, not that one over there. Now, you want something to do, you come over here and help your granddaddy serve up this barbecue. Now, who wants some ribs? Hey, y'all kids better get off my damn lawn, else I'm gonna cut your feet off. And that's right, you better disperse. I'm serious about my grass.
And then my grandmother would be like,
Beatrice, what you got in your mouth? That better not be those strawberries I am growing over by the garage. Ooh, I am gonna hang you upside down by your feet and tickle those little toes till I get every last strawberry back.
Well, it's been so nice to meet you and to see your beautiful house, Beatrice. I do have to be on my way now.
Okay, well, it was nice to meet you, Mr. Silong.
Hey, please tell your uncle that
Thank you, everyone. See you at church. And don't forget to sign that fair housing petition on the way out. Okay, Rex, I'm done with choir rehearsal. Do you have time for private conversation?
Oh, well, geez, Mr. Opinaldo,
Ma, now can you take baby Ephraim back?
Yes, come here, baby. Oh, hi, honey. Hi, of course I'll take you, baby.
Good, because I think he pooped.
He did. He pooped. Now, Gregorio convinces Rex to stick around for a few more minutes. He manages to fill Rex in on the situation with America's servicing company before Rex has to leave. And after that, life at 2656 Brighton Avenue goes on as usual.
Nathaniel, get off the phone and get started on your homework.
We'll after dinner.
Ma, what are you making?
Uncle, what did you and Mr. Salonga talk
That's
about?
That's not any of your concern, guys.
Pasta string beans, please.
Be careful, Uncle. You don't know this guy, Rex.
You only get to my age by being careful, Beatrice.
Good night.
Good night, night everyone.
Good night.
Good night. Good night.
Somebody get eaten
up. Come on, Raphael. You're going to be late for school.
Oh, hash browns again?
I'm up.
Mm, yum, hash browns.
Uncle, you got another bill from the insurance people.
Don't touch my bills, Beatrice.
You have one new message sent on May 6, 2014 at 7:58 a.m.
Mr. Opinaldo, it's Rex Salonga. Hey, it was... really great to meet you and your family, and geez, that house, really special. Now, I appreciate you talking me through your situation, and you're right. America's servicing company shouldn't be giving you the runaround like they are, and, Well, I don't know if there's anything I can do about it, but when I was at your house, I mentioned my buddy Jim from St. Paul's. I knew he worked at some bank, but then Rebecca reminded me that Jim actually works at ASC. Well, you can't know everything, so it's good to know a lot of people, right? So I gave him a call and left a message just to see if he had any ideas, you know? And we'll see if anything comes of it. Maybe it's a long shot, but what the heck? We're people of faith, right? Okay, God bless.
Yolanda, set the table for dinner, please.
Uncle, what are we eating?
Adobong shita.
For what we are about to receive, let us be truly
Beatrice,
thankful.
It's official. Rex is going to help modify our loan.
Uncle, haven't we heard this before?
Not from a Filipino brother, no.
Ma, I can't brush my teeth because Eden's still in the bathroom.
No, I'm not.
Good night, everyone.
Good night. Good night. How do y'all want y'all eggs?
Scrambled.
Uncle, does Rex seem a little too eager to help out?
I trust the man, Beatrice.
But he...
I don't feel good. Can I stay home from school?
If she's staying home, I'm staying home.
Absolutely not.
One new message sent on June 12, 2014.
Hi, Mr. Opinaldo. Rex here. Hey, following up. I just talked to Jim, and I can't promise anything, but he thinks he can lower your payments by $300, $400, maybe $500 a month. You see, what Jim tells me is that the most surefire way to get ASC to modify your loan is to fall behind on your mortgage payments. I know, it sounds weird, right? But Jim explained it to me, and we need to establish the appearance of an inability to pay. It's actually pretty straightforward if you think about it. Anyway, call me back. Rebecca and I are looking forward to coming to St. Agnes one of these Sundays. All right. God bless, brother.
Good morning, Ephraim.
Beatrice, Rex is coming by the house tomorrow.
Wait, wasn't he just here?
Who put the empty milk carton in the fridge? Again?
We're having what we had last night.
For what we are about to receive, let us be truly thankful.
Good night, everyone.
Good night. Good
night. Good night, y'all. Hey, Hill, what time did you get home last night?
Ego or Pop-Tarts?
Lego, my ego.
Uncle, if we sell the Continental, we can pay Nathaniel's too.
I love that car, Beatrice. Come on in and have a seat, Rex.
Thank you, brother. Is, everything okay? You sounded a little shook up over the phone.
No, it's just that, well, I appreciate what you're trying to do for us with the loan and everything, Rex, but maybe you can ask your friend Jim if there is another way. I haven't ever fallen behind on my payments, and I don't want to start now.
Sure. Yeah, I mean, I get it. And like I said, if you're not 100% comfortable, we can just walk away, you know? So no problem. I'll just tell Jim thanks, but no thanks.
Well, yes, maybe you should do that. Consider it done, brother. Good, good. Rex, maybe you know a lawyer I can speak with instead.
Yeah. I'll look into that for sure.
Thank you.
Of course, brother. Is Beatrice home?
No, she's not. Why?
Oh, nothing really. I brought her this barbecue apron. Rebecca and I had an extra, and I thought maybe Beatrice could use it. Would you mind giving it to her?
Yes, I will. It's very nice of you and Rebecca.
Oh, it's our pleasure. You know, before I go, brother, I just want to say that Jim mentioned that he's done this with many other loan clients, and it's never been a problem.
Yes, but my credit score...
Oh, it won't hurt your credit.
It won't?
No. Because like you said, you've always paid on time, right?
Right. I have.
And even I know that goes a long way with the bank. That's all there is to it. After a couple of months, you're going to get that loan modification. And then you'll pay the bank the money you set aside, and everyone's happy. It's a win-win.
I don't know, Rex.
Sure. Like I say, you're the boss, so, sleep on it. But listen, if you do want to do this, I'm going to be with you every step of the way, okay?
You will.
I will. I promise, brother. And no pressure, okay? Just give me a call when you've given it some more thought, and, hey, listen, I got to get going. Rebecca and I are volunteering for the church supper. You're going to call me, right? It's just I need to tell Jim one way or another. You get it.
Yes, I'll call you.
That's great. Well, you say hi to Beatrice and the kids. I'll talk to you soon, brother.
Yes, Talk to you soon, Rex.
America's Servicing Company, how may I direct your call?
Hey, Tina, it's Rex.
Hey, Rex, what's up?
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good, good, good. So check it out. You're not going to believe it. I think I got another one.
Oh, you did?
I should know in a few days. Meantime, can you tell Pete to go ahead and draw up the papers for 2656 Brighton Avenue?
I sure can. 2656?
Yep, that's right. Brighton. He's a real sucker. B-R-I-G-H-T-O-N. I think it's 90008.
Yeah, all right. I'll tell him.
We'll do the same percentage as last time. We'll give him your number.
Yeah, that works.
Beautiful. All right. Thanks, Tina.
Thank you.
Well, if we had any doubts about Rex, now at least we know where he stands. But Gregorio doesn't. Is he going to see through Rex? Or will he, like so many of us, see what he wants to see?
Next new message, sent on October 10, 2014, at 1:34 p.m.
Brother Opinaldo, it's Rex. Hey, that is some great news. You've decided to let Jim and me help you out. Now, we need to just set some money aside. Keep your bank balance low, right? That's the key. So, to help with that, and only if you're comfortable with this, you can write a check each month for your mortgage, insurance, and property taxes to my company, Stonecrest Mortgage Corp. And I'll hold the payments for you until the loan modification comes through. Hey, I can even pick up the check in person each month. That way we don't have to take chances with the U.S. Postal Service, or as I like to call them in my house, the useless Postal Service. Anyway, it's really just a good excuse for me to visit with you and Beatrice and Luna and Eden and Cahill, Nathaniel, Yolanda, Emmalou, Gaia, Raphael, Judah, and little baby Ephraim. God bless, brother. Proud of you.
Well, hi there, Cahill, isn't it?
I'm Gaia.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry, Gaia. I won't forget next time, I promise. My name is Rex, and I'm here to see you.
I know. Uncle, Mr. Rex is here to see you.
Ho, ho, ho. Tis the season, Emmalou. How are you this morning?
Merry Christmas. Good?
I brought you this teen Bible. My kids really like it.
Thank you. Uncle! Mr. Rex is here to see you.
Gregorio continues to scrape together whatever he can to cover the mortgage, home insurance, and property tax. Every first of the month, he combines it all into a check to Rex's company.
Mr. Opinaldo, happy Easter to you and your lovely niece and all the kids. Oh, hey, speaking of the good news, we got the loan modification. Congratulations! Didn't I tell you there was nothing to worry about? The new rate is almost $200 less than your current rate. You'll only be paying $19.50 a month. Hey, $19.50, isn't that the year your mother bought that house? I'm getting chills right now. God is good, right? Until we get the paper signed, be sure to keep making those checks out to Stonecrest Mortgage Corp. Congratulations, brother. I'll see you soon when I drop by for the check.
Well, hi there, Yolanda. I brought you that new pair of earbuds I promised you.
Thank you, Rex. Uncle, Mr. Rex is here to see you.
Hi, Cahill. Bet you're glad school's out for summer, huh? Here's that basketball I promised you. Think quick.
Oh, sweet. Uncle, Mr. Rex is here again.
Hiya, Gaia. How do you like these red, white, and blue headbands my wife picked out for July 4th?
Oh, cool. So pretty. Thanks, Mr. Rex. Uncle, Mr. Rex is here.
Hi, Luna. Whew, is it hot enough for you today? Look, I got
Uncle.
You
a... Uncle!
Hi, Eden.
Uncle. Oh, hello, Rex.
Hi there, Beatrice. I just stopped by to
see
you.
Oh, I'm so sorry. You know, he's asleep right now.
Who's at the door?
He must have just woken up. Come on in, Rex.
Uncle.
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 Uncle. Mr. Rex is here again.
Rex, I have a question. It's been 7 months since I began writing checks to Stonecrest Mortgage Corp. And I haven't gotten the loan modification yet. I'm starting to wonder if,
To delete this message, press 7. To save this message, press 9. To begin again, press pound.
Yeah, Brother Opinaldo, it's Rex here. Listen, I wanted you to hear it from me first. You may have a small problem. See, I got a call from America's Servicing Company saying that they got a call from the Los Angeles County Tax Collector saying that you, brother, have not been paying your property taxes, and so they, ASC, they canceled the loan. Now, it's nothing I can't handle. I'm in touch with Jim to see if we can get the loan reinstated, so hang in there, okay? Keep the faith. Salonga
is not available at this time. Please leave a message after the tone.
Rex, you. I have been paying my property taxes. I've been, paying them to you.
Ma, who put this sign on our front door?
Ma, what does foreclosure mean?
Why does it say 2 weeks to vacate premise?
Why is Uncle crying?
Tell your uncle I need to talk to him.
It's not my turn to set the table.
For what we are about to receive, let us be truly safe.
Is Uncle coming down for dinner?
Good night, everyone.
Good night, everybody.
Good night, you all.
Sleep well.
Salonga
is not available. To send this message, press is not available. To send this, press 9. To begin again, press pound. Press pound. Begin again, press pound. Press pound. Is not available.
Rex Salonga.
The mailbox is full and cannot accept any messages at this time. Goodbye.
I found 2 more towels in the closet. Here, Eden, put them with the others.
This box is completely full.
Just take it.
Nathaniel, Oh, we gotta pack them someplace else. Judah, pass me the packing tape.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks.
Wait, Ma, what are we gonna do with the barbecue grill?
Yeah.
Just leave it, Luna. The yard at the rental house ain't big enough.
What?
Can you take Granddaddy's bass
fiddle? No, Raphael, we don't have room.
Oh, come on, we can't take anything.
Oh, remember this music box?
That's for little kids, Gaia.
Oh, I'm still a little kid.
What, do we really have to leave, Ma?
Yes.
Why?
We'll talk about it later.
Ruff.
I don't want
to
go.
Mr. Rex coming to say goodbye?
What?
He said he'd bring me a Pokemon.
He said he'd bring me a selfie stick.
Raphael, have you seen your uncle?
He's in the bathroom saying the same thing over and over.
Okay, you kids keep packing. Eden, you're in charge.
No.
I gotta go talk to your uncle.
How come she's always in charge? I'm old enough.
I got a lawyer, filed a petition, got a court date, gonna get my house back. I got a lawyer.
Uncle!
Filed a petition, got a court date, gonna get my house back. I got a lawyer, filed a petition.
Uncle, can you open the door, please?
Beatrice, I'm gonna get this house back.
Uncle, we have to go. You know this.
You know I'm gonna bring that man to justice.
Okay, but for now, we need to be taking care of our own selves and forget about him. Listen, I found us a place to stay.
This is our place, Beatrice.
I found a house we can rent in Hemet in the desert, about 100 miles east of here. Now, it's not much space, but we can afford it, and the kids will have plenty of room outside to run around.
Beatrice, I can't...
You will have a bedroom to yourself, and the rest of us will just share the other room, at least until we get on our feet.
I'm not going.
As far as packing and moving, you don't have to worry about a thing. The kids and I will finish packing up this weekend. I'll rent a truck and haul it all out there.
I can't go, Beatrice. I have to stay. I got a lawyer. I filed a petition. I got a court date. I'm going to get my house
it's
back.
It's over, Uncle. He preyed on you. He preyed on all of us. Look, I found out he has done this to people all over California, all people over 65. They trusted him just like you did.
I did. I trusted him.
And that's what he does. He gets people to trust him, then he takes the money and he keeps it and never pays their loan payments. And they didn't even get notices that their houses were up for sale until their homes were sold right out from under them, just like us. So come on, Uncle. It's late and I can tell you're tired. And honestly, I am too. Let's gather up the kids. We'll all go out together. Come on. It's not your fault, Uncle. You can't know everything. And Rex Kalanga, he's a snake.
That's why he needs to go to jail.
So come with us now, Uncle. We can fight from him and I will help you.
Go ahead and get the kids in the car. I'll be there in a few minutes. I just need to gather a few things.
You promise?
I promise, sir. Go on, Beatrice. Let's see. Rex, this is a... That's not right. Rex, this is a... Rex, I invited you into my home, didn't I? And you called me brother. For 2 years, you said you were my Filipino brother. And the whole time, you were taking my money. You think I'm an old fool? Well, I'm the kind of old fool you don't want to mess with, Rex Kalanga. I got a lawyer, I filed a petition, I got a court date, I'm gonna get my house back. Because I have all these children I need to think about. Okay, that's good. Here we go.
What does hunger sound like in America? And why would we ask that question and then tell a story that hardly mentions it? In episode 2, you'll meet the real-life Beatrice, her uncle Gregorio, and their family. They'll teach us how to hear hunger in every moment of this story. You'll learn about where the family is now and how the foreclosure has impacted their lives. You'll meet the actors and learn about the making of the episode you just heard. That's next time on Pang. The creative team behind Pang includes actors Natalie Communis, Christina Fernandez, Donna Simone Johnson, and Christopher Rivas. Composer Robert Ian, producer Ari Anderson, dramaturg Bobby Gordon, and writer, producer, and director Dan Fruit. We are ably assisted by Tula B. Strong and Nicole Bergelson. Pang was recorded and mastered by Casey Wayland at Wayland Productions in Orange, California. The music was recorded and edited by Ross Levinson at iEar Music in Santa Monica, California. Editing by Dan Fruit. You've been listening to Pang.